And Taylor Swift is, of course, arguably the biggest pop star in the world right now, which is literally huge, isn't she, in the studio. Millions of fans, or Swifties as they're known, are gearing up for her eagerly anticipated Eras Tour coming to the UK next month.
Now, for those of us who couldn't get hold of a ticket, that's quite a few, to be fair, the University of Liverpool is going to be hosting a special Tay Day celebrating the global cultural phenomenon that is Taylor Swift.
We will find out more in just a minute, but first, let's just hear some of one of our greatest hits. That won't take long. Her greatest hits. You might recognise them. So it's gonna be forever, or it's gonna go down in flames. You can tell me when it's over, if the high was worth the pain. Got a long list of ex-lovers, they'll tell you I'm insane. Cos you know I love the players, and you love the game. It's me, high, I'm the problem, it's me. I'm the problem, it's tea time, everybody agrees. I'll stare directly at the sun, but never in the mirror. It must be exhausting, always rooting for the anti-hero. Cos the player's gonna play, 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 play.
She's going to be quite big.
Do you?
She's good, yeah, she's quite good, yeah.
Do you think she can write a tune?
Yeah.
We're joined now by Dr. Amy Shawseth, who's from the Institute of Popular Music at the University of Liverpool and one of the hosts of Tay Day at the university. Tell us how this is going to work.
It's such a pleasure to be able to talk about this today. So the event is massive. And what's really important to Sam Murray and I, who's organizing this with me, is that for fans who can't afford tickets to the Taylor Swift Eras Tour, they're going to be able to attend this free event, which is from 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. on June 12th. And it's going to be a lot of variety of different conversations around Taylor.
Okay, what are the conversations around Taylor then?
So many. From
how she even start?
From how she writes her songs. She's known for being a songwriter. The immense craft of her lyrics, which are even read as poetry. We'll have some of that. We'll have her vinyl distribution. Someone is even talking about a Taylor Swift millipede.
Hey.
So the importance of that for science communication is huge, to spread the word about new discoveries.
Well, a millipede that has been named after her.
Correct, yes.
Hey.
the unexpected.
So, and your connection, you're an academic.
Correct.
And you've studied music.
I study music and popular culture. Media, exactly, and culture and society, and her impact has been huge.
Oh, just to explain, to people who are watching, everybody will recognise the tunes, but if they're not fans, but they're watching right now, just explain that global impact of Taylor Swift.
Yes, so Taylor Swift has a huge fandom, and, you know, notably, of course, has been a lot of teenage girls and a lot of girls who kind of grew up with her, around my age, actually, my generation. But that has expanded because she's produced so many different albums that have gotten a big range of fans. Even senior academics, you know, male academics, have become massive fans of hers.
Now, and what is it about her that has captured the imagination so much?
I think it's the way that she has changed and transformed her image across all of these eras. And this is why the eras concept is so important to her across these 11 albums.
It's quite clever, isn't it?
Yes, it's a brilliant marketing strategy because popular musicians, they do change their image. They have personas that they present to the public. And she has managed to go from a country singer and songwriter to pop to kind of more indie folk rock. So she's transformed herself amazingly and gotten all these fans.
A modern day Madonna, is that fair?
Absolutely, but plus so many other folks. You know, we've got a little bit of Dolly. We've got so many different intersections. And of course, she's working with Bon Iver and these other producers who are helping her to reach these different fan communities and also write and express herself and the issues that she sees around her.
She does, how can I put this? If people don't like her, they really don't like her. Why is that?
She has a very polarizing from the Swifties to the haters, right? Yeah. And that's absolutely
true. Why is
that? Well, It's the fact that she's become a massive businesswoman. It's still incredibly gendered to have this much success as a woman. That's something we really want to raise awareness on, especially for all of the young fans. I know fans who are 4 years old, right, who are looking up to her. And, you know, as a music industry that's been dominated by a lot of men, you know, coming from Liverpool, the city of the Beatles, that's incredible that she has managed to have this huge industry and this impact.
What would you say to people watching this morning who are thinking, hang on a minute, academics could be studying Jane Austen, but why bother with Taylor Swift?
It's because we can study so many different things through her. She helps us to learn not only about the music industry, the process of writing songs and having a business, but also the possible way of getting involved in politics. She's been organizing in the past in the US elections, to the ways that we can think about fandom and the way that you can sort of market yourself. We can think about branding through her. We can also think about pop stars' environmental impacts. She's famously known for flying these private jets around. We can think about the ways that she and her marketing teams use social media. I mean, it really runs the gamut, like I was saying, from science to environment to fans to gender. It's really amazing the amount of topics that she can help us explore.
So University of Liverpool, you're hosting it middle of June?
That's correct, on June 12th.
Okay.
Tickets are free. You're available to sign up at our ticket source.
Have you got a ticket for the actual Eras tour?
I have not, but
Sam does.
Oh,
you're kidding me.
I know, so I'll have to get all of the stories from him. But that's in part what's so interesting, is being able to share in these conversations. And that's why Sam and I wanted to have this event in the Department of Music and the Institute for Popular Music, which is the oldest of its kind at a university, to be able to bring people in who might not be able to access this event and have the conversations that they've wanted to have that run the gamut of all of the different impacts that she has.
Dr. Amy Schuster, thank you very much indeed for coming in.
Thank
it sounds
you
great.
So
Good
much.
Luck with
a
it.
Pleasure.
Enjoy.